So I'm going to invite you all to take that comfortable seat. So legs stretched out or crossed or whatever feels good for you, and just start to focus on your breath. And then I want you to take one hand and put it just above your pubic bone. And as you're breathing, notice how your hand moves, if your hand moves. And I want you to see if you can become aware of your lower abdominals contracting as you exhale. And without changing your breath or forcing it, just seeing what comes up. And then whenever you feel ready, you can release your hand and take a breath and notice how you're feeling and set your intention. So how do you want to feel after we're done with practice today? And then when you're ready, if your eyes are closed, open them up. And we're going to take the feet out into a wide stance. And if you're sitting on something, it'll probably be easier if you bring your butt to the floor just for what we're going to do. And you're going to take your hands a little bit behind you. And I want you to bring one knee at a time in towards the center and see if your one leg, the leg that's not moving, remains stationary. So you're just kind of seeing how it feels to move one leg. And if you need a little padding, keep that under your butt.
It's more just my legs don't want to move.
And if you need to take them a little bit wider, you can do that. You know, for those of you with longer legs, or if it just helps you to move more freely. And then we're going to eventually pause doing that and bring the bottoms of our feet together. And just very gently wiggle in your knees a little bit, up and down. And just seeing how that feels. And you can use your hands to help you sit upright if you find yourself kind of falling backwards. And then, this is going to be interesting. You're going to see how this goes. You're going to keep your left leg bent like it is in front with that angle. And then you're going to take your right knee and place it down on the ground. And give yourself enough room. And if you need some padding under that knee, see how that feels. And notice how it feels in your body. And then we're going to keep the left hand down on the ground. Reach up with your right hand. Inhale as you reach over. And exhale, come up. And know that this, your left hand on the ground, it's there for balance. Try to keep your weight in your hips, right? Don't put all of your weight into that hand. Obviously, there's going to be some. One more time. And then when you come up, very carefully, bring in that right knee, and you're going to place that at a, you know, horizontal position to your body. And then bring your left knee out. Place that right hand down on the ground. Reach up, and then inhale, come over to the side. Exhale, come up. So as you're moving, noticing what you feel in your body, how your breath moves. This will be our last time. And when you come on up again, you're going to carefully lift up that left knee and then your right knee and find those tennis balls. You might have been thinking we were going to not use the tennis balls today, but good morning. And so you're going, your butt stays on the ground. You're going in front of your sits bones. Then you're going to stretch out your legs a little bit. And I want you to roll through the pelvis. And then maybe even take your knees side to side and seeing if you can feel those connectors. If it's too much, back off or get rid of the tennis balls. You can always just massage with your hands if the tennis balls are too much for you. And then we're going to take those tennis balls and we're going to put them under your calves. And try to get them right in the center. And then you're going to see if you can keep your heels on the ground. And then we're going to point and flex the feet and open and close the legs. How are those calves today? Can you feel them? Now, depending on what's behind you, you're going to move your body back so that the tennis balls start to make it down towards your heels. So you can leave the calves, you go to the soleus, and then the Achilles, and then the heels. So how are those backs of your lower legs doing today? And you can point and flex, you can roll in and out, just kind of see what feels best in your body as you're going through these. Now, eventually, some of you might be really grateful. We're going to take the tennis balls out, and I want you to run your fingers from the tips of your toes up your leg all the way to your hip. Kind of like a sweeping motion, maybe a little massaging motion, but sweeping up. And we're going to do the second leg from the tips of the toes all the way up. Okay. All right. Now, how's everybody doing so far? Okay. We're going to come on to our hands and knees. So if you'd like to have a blanket under your knees, go ahead and place that down there. So your wrists are slightly in front of your shoulders, knees slightly behind your hips. And I want you to, just like we did when we were sitting down, I want you to bring your awareness to the lower abdominals and see if you can feel when they naturally contract on your exhale. Now, once you feel that connection, or whenever you're ready, we're going to inhale up here, exhale down towards child's pose, and moving slowly with your breath. Inhale is up, exhale is down. And if it doesn't work being on your hands, you could be on your elbows. Just breathing and moving and noticing how your body feels as you do so. And the next time you come up, we're going to bring the right hand to center. And again, you could be on a block on your elbow, you know, kind of see what works for your wrist, right? We're going to take our vision onto the left hand, and you're going to start to inhale up, exhale down, staying on the same side. Inhale up, seeing if you can track your hand with your eyes. So you're looking at the hand as you're moving, and you're only coming up to a place that feels good. One more time, and then we're going to bring that left hand to center. Look at the right hand, and again, start to inhale that hand up, exhale back. Morning. And next time you come back down, we're going to center our hands. And then what I want you to do is keep your hands or your elbows on the ground. And you're going to try to keep your arms straight, and we're going to drop the chest down. So we're trying to isolate moving your chest up and down. So don't bend those elbows to the best of your ability. See if you can drop your chest and then lift it up. Okay. And I know that's a lot of work for some of us, so pausing for a moment. We're going to come up onto the fingertips. All right. Inhale up here, exhale, come down towards child's pose. And it might be a little bit of a different movement because you're up on your fingertips. Carefully moving with your breath. Nice. Next time you come up, we're going to stretch out the left arm and the right leg, keeping your vision towards the ground. Engage your muscles by flexing that back foot. And if it works better for you, you can just do the arms or the legs. On an exhale, we're going to bring that hand and knee down and then take the second side. Breathing, holding, feeling your muscles, feeling your breath. Again, on an exhale, we're going to take the hand and knee down and come back into child's pose or puppy pose, whatever feels better in the body this morning. And when you inhale up, I want you to walk your hands away a little bit. Inhale up and come into some level of cobra. And again, you could be on your elbows or you can be on your hands. Right? Finding that place that works for you. And then the movement will be inhale here, exhale back towards child's pose or cobra pose. Moving with your breath, inhaling forward, exhaling back. And noticing, paying close attention to how that low back feels as you're moving front to back with your breath. And next time, come forward, let's come to a tabletop and we're going to step forward with your left foot. And you might have blocks towards the front of your mat for your hands. We're going to slide that back knee back a little bit so it's behind your hip. So the front knee is over the ankle, the back knee is behind the hip. And just noticing how that feels. And if you haven't done so already, I want you to turn your back toes under because we're going to lift that back knee off the ground. Right? And then gently touch down or bend that knee and straighten. Moving through. So for the most part, the front part of our body is, you know, not moving except as it needs to move your bent knee. Now, next time you come towards the ground, let's place that knee on the ground. We're going to step that front foot back and take your second foot forward. And again, give yourself a little bit of time to get yourself set up, right? So front knee over the ankle, back knee behind the hip, breathing. And then whenever you're ready, turning those back toes under, lifting up your knee, and bending and straightening that back knee. Keep breathing. This will be our last time. So this time when your leg is straight, well, you might bend it a little bit. We're going to step forward with that back foot. Woohoo! And then bring those hands onto your legs. Inhale, halfway up. And exhale in towards your legs. Now one of these inhales, we're going to come all the way up. Make sure you're not too dizzy. If you have stuff on your mat, you might move it out of the way. We're going to find one tennis ball. So catch your breath. Notice how you're feeling. When you're ready, we're going to roll one foot on the tennis ball. Feet have been very interesting to me lately. When you finish that first foot, we'll move on to the second. So when you finish that second foot, we're going to put the tennis ball aside, and you might see I have a wooden dowel. Like, I think these are commonly used in closets, you know, like that would be the size that we're working with. If you don't have one of these at home, you can use a strap. But I think this is I have these in my home too, like they're a nice tool to have. So how I want you to start is with your hands a little bit wider than your hips. And we're going to inhale those arms up. Exhale, bend your elbows and take the stick behind your head. Inhale up and exhale forward. Just kind of noticing how it feels as you bend those elbows, how does it feel in your shoulders, in your chest? Next time that you come forward, you're going to keep your stick in one hand, and I have my thumb pointing down, but you're going to see what works for your body, and you're going to take it behind you. And so now I have one hand on the top, one hand on the bottom, and if at any time you need to switch hands because your arms get tired, go ahead and do that. So I want you to see if you can feel the stick on your head, on your upper back, and on your tailbone. Butt somewhere, right? And we're going to inhale up, exhale into a little squat. And notice, like, you're going to bend at the hips, you're going to bend at the ankles, the knees, but you're keeping your body in line with the stick. So let your hips bend. So your head's going to come forward a little bit and the stick is going to come forward with you. One more time. Up, we're going to let go with the stick and bring it forward. How is that for everybody? A little wonky. Now, you're going to hold on to your stick. You're going to take your block. But maybe today is the day. How many props can we use in the class? You're going to place the block between your thighs in a way that's comfortable. And we're going to hold the stick again in a comfortable distance, right? So you don't want your hands too close together or too far apart. So find that comfortable distance. You're going to inhale up and exhale into a little chair. Let your hips bend and see if you can feel those abdominals. Obviously, there's a theme today, right? Connecting with those lower abdominals as you're breathing and moving. And of course, you're pressing into the center because we're holding on. Let those hips bend. Some of you are kind of keeping your back straight. Let your butt stick out a little bit as you come down. And if you're not sure, those in the room can turn around and look in the mirror. Last time. Now you're going to come down. And if the stick is too heavy, just rest it on your thighs. We're going to come up onto the toes, lifting the heels, finding your balance. Breathe, keep breathing. Can you feel those lower abdominals here? You might be feeling other things too. We're gonna exhale, take those heels down, relax the stick at your lap. And we're gonna take the block out. Now beware of your neighbors, or if you're at home, beware of stuff around you. We're gonna take our, it's gonna be a steering wheel now. Right, and you're gonna just go back and forth. Inhale, exhale. Well, this is nice and easy. This is how I drive sometimes. Kidding, not kidding. Okay, and then relax, shake them out. Now, this particular thing we do, this pose, we do with a strap often. I want you to take the stick into your right hand, bring the stick behind you, and then you're gonna walk your left hand up to meet it, right, to a comfortable place. Okay, then we're gonna step that right foot forward. You're gonna keep your feet hip width apart. So you definitely want some distance, maybe like a meter between your feet. Both feet are pointing forward. So again, you're holding on to the stick, top and bottom. It's touching your head and your tailbone. We're gonna inhale up, engage your feet as you kind of exhale forward. Don't go too far, inhale up, and don't let that stick leave your butt, right? And it's not about like, it has to be so precise. It's about trying to keep that alignment in our body as we inhale up and exhale forward. So, and when you pull the legs towards one another, you might feel those lower abdominals engaging. So next time you come up, let go of your bottom hand, bring the stick forward, step your feet together. Take a breath. So we've done that pose lots of times, not usually with a stick. So notice, like, especially what's going on in the low back and your core as we're doing that. And if you find your low back at all instigated, I want you to not hardly bend at all on the second side. So now you're gonna take it into your, the stick into your left hand on top, right hand on the bottom. When you're ready, step forward with that left foot. And again, pull the legs towards one another, right? So you feel those muscles engaging. I can feel it move all the way right up into my core. Inhale up, exhale, come forward. And again, it doesn't need to be a big movement to be effective. I think sometimes we want to push ourselves like as far as we can go, but really, as soon as you feel those muscles engage, like it's working. Like I can feel it as soon as my body starts to lean forward, even an inch or two. So inhale up, exhale forward. I'm gonna do it one more time. And when you come up, again, releasing your arms, releasing the stick, stepping those feet back together. We're gonna put the sticks in a safe place. Bye, stick. Some of you may be happy to see them go, others maybe not. So here, I want you to just have your feet a comfortable distance apart. Bend those ankles, knees, hips, just wiggle a little bit or roll through your pelvis. Seeing if you can let go of any tension that might have developed while we were doing that. And then we're going to reach up with that right hand and then hold on to your right wrist or arm, wherever it's comfortable. And I want you to move really slowly here, right? I don't want you to just fling yourself over to the side. I want you to start to make your way over and notice how it feels into your arm, your armpit, your side body, hip maybe. Don't go too far. Then on an inhale, we'll come up, switch sides. And again, ever so slowly start to come over to the side, paying attention to the sensations as you're moving. Keep breathing. Don't go too far. And then when you're ready on an inhale, come up, release those arms, roll through your shoulders. And then we'll roll one shoulder at a time. And you just say, like, notice when we did that, where did you feel sensation, if you felt sensation? Now from here, we're going to, and some of you may want to go to a wall or the bar in the back of the room, we're going to reach for your right ankle. And if your hand doesn't come to your ankle, you can use a strap there. We're gonna see if you can move that knee front to back without taking it to the side, meaning that you don't want it to move out to the side, right? You wanna keep it close to your standing leg as you're moving front to back. Now, one of these times, you're going to keep that knee slightly behind your standing leg and slide your left arm forward. Start to take that heel away from your buttock. So now you're making space between your heel and your buttock. And then possibly you're going to start to come forward with your heart. Keep breathing. Seeing if you can maintain that space between your heel and your butt. Keep breathing. And then on one of these inhales, when you're ready, you're going to inhale, slide on up. Carefully release that foot to the ground. Bring your hands onto your thighs. Inhale, body up. Let your knees be soft here. Exhale, slide forward. And we'll inhale halfway up and exhale in towards your legs a few times with your breath. Always noticing how your body is feeling as we go through each of our motions. On an inhale, come on all the way up. And then when you're ready, taking your weight into the right leg, reaching for your left ankle, bringing that heel near your buttock, and then possibly starting to move that knee front to back. And you might notice a difference side to side, continuing to breathe. One of these times, keeping that knee behind your standing leg or next to your standing leg, wherever it's comfortable, then making space between your heel and your buttock, sliding that right arm forward, and then possibly reaching your chest towards the ground. Keep breathing. Breathe. On one of these inhales, allow your body to come up, gently release that foot. Take both hands onto your thighs. Inhale, body up, exhale, down. And again, then we'll inhale halfway up, exhale into your forward bend. Letting your knees be soft. On one of these inhales, coming all the way up. And again, we're still working with balance, so you could have one hand on the wall or one hand on your hip. What we're going to do is I want you to step forward with your right toes and then out to the side, back, and forward. So you're touching down at each of those three points and breathing. One more time. And come back to that neutral position and then second side, front, side, still breathing as you're moving. And I know really simple movements, yet noticing how your body and your breath respond to the motions. One more time. Coming back to that neutral point, shifting your weight into the left foot again. And this time we're going to come out to the side, cross over in front, out to the side, cross over and back. So as you're doing this, you're breathing and you're noticing how your balance, how your hips, how your legs are responding. Next time you go to the back is when we'll be done. So coming back to that neutral position, taking a breath. And then shifting your weight into the right, and again, stepping out to the side, crossing over in front, out to the side, crossing over and back. Breathing and focusing. And one more time, next time you come to the back, back to that neutral position. And here we're going to slide down, and if you're at the wall, you may want to come back to your mat. We're going to slide down and take your hands onto the floor or the blocks, and then walk your feet wide. Right, so you have your hands on your block, your feet are wide, maybe as wide as your mat, looking for that comfortable place. And again, the arms, to the best of your ability, are going to stay straight. You're going to bend ankles, knees, and hips like you're trying to bring your butt to the ground. Inhale as you straighten the legs, exhale as you bend. Still breathing as you're moving, noticing how your body is responding. And then from here, we're going to come down into a squat. So you might do a wide-legged squat if that feels good. You might bring your feet in a little bit. You might put a blanket under your heels or a block under your butt, looking for a somewhat comfortable position. You could also take your back against the wall. And then your hands might be at your forehead or your heart center. Like, can you find a place of comfort and ease in the squatting position? Is that a yes or a no? Keep breathing. Nice, I like that one, Francesca.
I'm 6 feet off the ground.
That's okay. Your butt's off the ground. That's, you know, that's half the battle. So from here, we're going to carefully take your hands down to the ground, take your butt down to the ground. If you have stuff underneath you, just being aware of how you're doing that.
You could also hang from the bar.
Yeah, that's I actually love to do that.
When I was pregnant, I would hang off my kitchen counter.
Yeah, great idea. Okay, so here we are, down on the ground. I want you to stretch out your legs. If you'd like a block under your sitz, a blanket under your sitz bones, feel free to go ahead and do that. And your legs are stretched out, and hands onto your thighs. We're going to inhale up, exhale, come forward. But I want you to, so it's not like this where your head is coming towards your body. I want you to think about coming forward with your heart, which for most of us means it'll be a smaller movement, right? We're trying to get the movement in the hips as opposed to like moving through our shoulders and our rib cage. So inhale up, exhale, come forward. And notice, like, notice what you feel in your butt, in the backs of your legs, in your belly. You're just kind of, I'm inviting you to be aware of what's happening in your body today. One more time. And when you come up, we're going to take your left foot, and I want you to do this without your hands if you can, and put it to your inner thigh. Now, if your knee is up in the air, you might put a blanket or a block underneath it. And then I want you to notice your body. So your right leg is straight out, and your body, your chest and your waist, your body is facing forward, right? And we're going to take our hands onto that leg. Your foot is flexed on this leg. We're gonna inhale up, exhale, slide forward. You can round your back here. And just inhale up, and exhale, slide down. And as you're doing this, you're noticing, again, what's happening in your body as you move. So inhale is up, exhale is forward, paying close attention that there's no pain anywhere, right? Not like, oh, I can live with this. No, no pain. And I know for some of you who have chronic pain, it's like, I hurt all the time, you know, but if there's any intensification of what's normally there, please back off. Now, next time, and I'm going to turn to the side so that you can see my body. As you come forward, we're going to do what we did earlier. Try to keep that integrity of your spine without coming forward. Your foot is flexed. And then I want you to pay attention to your diaphragm. So right under your rib cage. Take a nice big inhale, and as you exhale, invite that diaphragm to come in. Inhale, it expands because that's what happens in the body. Exhale, gently, not like you're sucking in your gut. Slowly, as you exhale, allowing those abdominal muscles to contract like they naturally do. And I don't know about you, as soon as I start to do this, my temperature goes, like I can feel myself heating up. And it doesn't look like a lot is happening, but because we're, this is actually a great way to work on your core, right? Just by breathing. Now after your next exhale, we're gonna inhale, slide on up, straighten out your left leg, bring those hands onto your thighs, inhale, body up, exhale, slide forward. So this is coming back to our center, noticing how our body's feeling. And then on one of these inhales, when you come up, again, without using your hands, bringing that right foot. And again, if your knee is up in the air, use blanket, bolster block underneath. Left foot flexed, hands onto your thighs. Make sure your body is facing forward. And then inhale, body up, exhale, start to slide down. And this is where we're letting our body, the back body round. You're coming down as far as you comfortably can and moving with your breath. Now next time you come up on your inhale, this is where you're going to come forward, keeping your back straight and find that comfortable place, and then starting to focus on your breath. So your head is in line with your spine and your breathing, and you're paying close attention to that diaphragm, inhaling and exhaling. Paying close attention to that contraction. After your next exhale, on the inhale, we're going to come up and stretch out your legs, wiggle them a little bit, shake them up and down, wiggle your toes if that feels good. And then I want you to sit in a comfortable position. So it could be like this with your legs stretched. Some of you might prefer to be in a cross-legged position. You might have a little blanket under your sits bones. And we're going to keep the, and some of you might like a block under your hand. You're going to keep the left hand down on the ground. Inhale that right arm up. We did this earlier. Your butt stays on the ground as you come over. Then you're going to turn that palm forward and sweep it down to the ground. Inhale, reach up and over. Turn your palm forward, sweep it around and up. And moving at your own pace, noticing how that feels as you sweep around, up and over, come around. Allowing yourself to be a little bit flowy and creative. Next time you do that left side, it's where we're going to stop. And as you come to that neutral place, you might roll through your shoulders. We're going to work with the head for a moment. So on the exhale, bringing your chin towards your chest. And then very carefully bringing the left ear towards the left shoulder. So your chin stays forward. We're trying to stretch the side back of the neck. So you're coming forward and then moving to one side, coming forward, center, and moving to the other side. next time you finish your second side, on the inhale, let's bring the head up. And then, most of you have a bolster or blanket. What I want to do is, and I think a blanket would work best here. We're going to make a little, so I'm starting with the blanket in this position.
Tadasana of the blanket.
And then you're going to fold it into threes. So we end up with a little roll. And I know some of you might have wonky blankets. So open it up. And the thing is, that would work. So you can use it however you want. You're going to place it on your mat. And what I want on here is your rib cage and your head. And of course, everything included in those areas. Right? So you might put on socks and a shirt. This is the part of class where we're going to slow down. So if you heat it up, you might start to feel chilly. So when you come down, I want you to have that, your blanket under your rib cage and under your head. And then your legs are in whatever position is comfortable. And then if possible, you're going to open your arms out like scarecrow. What did you say?
Cactus.
Cactus. Yeah, I couldn't think of that word. So you got scarecrow instead.
That's okay.
Now, as you settle in, and you might have your arms out, some of you, your elbows may not come to the ground, or your hands may not come to the ground. Inhale is going to be with the arms out. Exhale, you're going to bring your elbows and your forearms towards one another. Inhale, open. Exhale, come together. When you feel like you've had enough of that, you're going to relax your arms for a moment. Bring them down to your sides. And just start to focus on your breath and how it feels in your body. Seeing if you can soften. Now, one thing here, because the blanket is not under your low back, you have to use your core muscles to keep it engaged so that it's not sagging down and hurting your low back. Now, if that's not possible for you, you can put the blanket all the way down your low back so that you're not having to work to keep it engaged. Okay? Now, one of these times, so some of you might like to stay here. If you would like to do some more movement, I'm going to invite you to inhale, one arm up, turn your head away from that arm, exhale, head back to the center arm, comes down, alternating sides. So again, you can choose to move or you can choose not to move. And if you're not sure, I like to, you know, ask my body. Body, do you feel like doing this movement? Would this like serve you? And see what the response is. And sometimes you start to move and it doesn't, you know, feel so good. And so then you stop. You know, you're just really asking yourself what will serve you. And then if you are moving the arms, you can continue to do that, or you can stop at any time. And we're going to relax here for a good minute and just see if you can let your shoulders soften towards the ground, rib cage and head supported, making sure the low back is engaged or supported by a blanket. Long, smooth breaths. So from here, you're welcome to stay in this position or to make it more comfortable somehow. We're going to move into Shavasana. So, of course, asking yourself, is there anything else that your body needs to feel comfortable? If so, go ahead and do that. And then set yourself up in a way that you'll be able to relax as completely as you can. And as you start to settle in, inviting your mind, your body, your breath to let go for the next bit of time, softening the eyes and the jaw, softening the back of the throat. Shoulders and your arms, your legs and your hips, your torso and your head. attempting to bring your awareness to your breath and to your body, noticing how you're feeling, and then thinking about what sort of movement would help you to gently reawaken. And then in your own time, starting to make your way up to a seated position. And at the beginning of class, I had you put a hand on the front of your torso, and now I'm going to invite you to put one in the front, one in the back, if that works for your body. And again, noticing how your body responds as you breathe. And if your arms get tired, just switch them. So can you perceive movement in the back of your body? Can you perceive movement in the front? Do they happen at the same time? Again, switching your hands if they get tired. Feel complete with this, releasing your hands. And then I'm going to invite you to do a little twist. We're going to take the left hand behind us, right hand onto the knee, and you're going to try to keep your body upright as you invite your chest over towards the left side. Notice what's happening in your shoulders as you're here, in your chest, in your torso. Can you still take a nice full breath in this twisted position? On one of your inhales, lengthening the spine, and exhale, coming forward. And then moving to the second side. And again, notice, instead of just, you know, whipping yourself over, slowly inviting your chest to the right, noticing how your hands are supporting you or not, your shoulders, your torso, spine nice and long, long, smooth breaths. And one of your inhales, lengthening the spine, exhale, coming forward. Today I feel like doing ohms. Anybody into ohms? And I don't know that all of you have done this before. I mean, I know you've all done ohms. But the way that I'd like to do it today is you do your ohm, and we'll do a continuous ohm. So whenever you're done with your ohm, you inhale again, and then you start to ohm. So because we have different lung capacities, there's going to be different lengths. Okay, so we're going to see how it goes. And we're going to go for three ohms at first. Okay, so nice big in-breath. Thank you all for being here. aware of your breath and your body. And I'd like to thank my teachers, past and present, and acknowledge the lands that I live and work upon. And that's it. Namaste.
Namaste.